Funding provided by...
Muskell Lighting is honored to support Iowa PBS. We're an Iowa company that lights local schools, community fields, and stadiums, arenas, and venues in more than 125 countries. While our reach is global, our commitment is local.
And by Fairway Meat and Grocery. For more than 80 years, Fairway has been proud to be an active part of the communities we serve. Learn more at fairway.com.
Across Iowa, hundreds of neighborhood banks strive to serve their communities, provide jobs, and help local businesses. Iowa banks are proud to back the life you build. Learn more at iowabankers.com.
With our Iowa roots and Midwestern values, Farmers Mutual Hale is committed to offering innovative farm insurance for America's farmers, just as we have for six generations. Farmers Mutual Hale, America's crop insurance company.
Welcome in to downtown Des Moines and inside of Wells Fargo Arena, where two teams will be crowned tonight in Class 5A and 3A. And then we're going to do three titles tomorrow here on Iowa PBS. We're all cheered up. The pom-poms are flowing. The adrenaline is rushing. And I'm Paul Yeager. Glad to have you here as we dive in for day one of our live girls state basketball tournament coverage. Iowa PBS will bring you highlights and features from right here on our on-site sports desk perched above the action. But first, let's go down courtside where my colleagues BJ Shaben and Laura Leonard are ready for their call of the 5A girls state championship.
Let's go. It is time for state championship basketball. First up, the Class 5A title game. How about this? A Central Iowa Metro League showdown as the third seed, Dowling Catholic, takes on unbeaten and number one seed, Johnston. Hi, get everyone with Laura Leonard. This is BJ Shaben, and this is going to be part three in the series between these two this year.
Yeah, Dowling has lost twice to Johnston, and Johnston has won them pretty handily. However, the second game was a very low-scoring game, kind of expecting that here tonight. I think Dowling's defense has improved over the course of the season. Johnston's a tough machine to try to shut down.
All right, there are going to be stars upon stars. Let's take a look at these two teams and how they got here for Dowling Catholic. You know what? They're celebrating their golden anniversary, their 25th trip to state. Not a bad run for the Maroons. They started 2-3, but they've won 19 of their last 20. And those stars for Johnston, take a look at this 10th trip to state. They're averaging about 72, and they have stars among stars that are going to be hitting the floor tonight.
Yeah, they really do. That is a tough lineup to try to pick one to try to shut down. You have to shut down all five.
Let's go to the public address announcer, Joe Hammond, to get introduced to these teams.
Dowling Catholic fans, let's hear it for your Maroons.
Johnston fans, let's hear it for your Dragons.
The Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union promotes good sportsmanship by participants, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants, officials, and spectators in a positive manner. Profanity, racial, sexist, or abusive comments or intimidating actions directed at officials, participants, coaches, team representatives, or event personnel will not be tolerated and are grounds for removal. We thank you for your cooperation and invite you to enjoy the game. Fans, it's now time to introduce the players in tonight's championship matchup. First and on starters for the Dowling Catholic Maroons. Number one, Sadie Reinhardt. Number 21, Kaylee Klein. Number 25, Maddie Rice. Number 31, Emma Hazel. Number 33, Macy Harnden. Number 35, Nellie Johnson. And number 41, Sophia Anthony Bodie. The assistant coaches for Dowling Catholic are Joel Danner, Audrey Faber, Tom Donahue, Lisa Smith, Jonathan Bandura, and Logan Greiner. And now let's meet the non-starters for the Johnston Dragons. Number 2, Isabella Balsley. Number 4, Sydney Pullman. Number 12, Cameron Jellick. Number 14, Ari Phillips. Number 20, Daya Phillips. Number 24, Avery Ryan. Number 32, Ruby Pullman. Number 34, Emma Gray. And number 40, Kaya Hood. The assistant coaches for Johnston are Mark Hine, Jenny Cook, and Brad Buchan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready for tonight's starting lineups? For Dowling Catholic at forward, a 5'10 junior number 5, Ellie Olson. And for Johnston at guard, a 5'10 sophomore number 10, Jenica Lewis. For Dowling Catholic at guard, a 5'11 freshman number 11, Katie Muller. And for Johnston at guard, a 5'9 senior, number 22, Aaliyah Riley. For Dowling Catholic at guard, a 5'10 junior, number 13, Ava Zedeker. And for Johnston at guard, a 5'6 sophomore, number 23, Jalea Kennitz. For Dowling Catholic at guard, a 5'9 junior, number 15, Layla Tritton. And for Johnston at forward, a 5'11 senior, number 30, Eileen Tankey. For Dowling Catholic at forward, a 6'2 sophomore, number 23, Ellie Muller. And for Johnston at forward, a 6'1 junior, number 42, Amani Jenkins. The head coach for Dowling Catholic is Kristen Meyer. And the head coach for Johnston is Chad Jillick. The floor officials this evening are Mark Worth, Matt Scholl, Patrick Emslinger, and the bench official is Dwayne Johnson. Welcome Dowling Catholic and Johnston to the 2024 Class 5A State Championship.
All right, here we go. Dowling Catholic, what are the keys to the game?
Well, what the Maroons need to do is force them into tough shots, make them uncomfortable from the perimeter, really limit the sight lines to getting the ball inside, and they need to limit the number of turnovers. In the regular season, last game against Johnston, they had 23 turnovers. Can't have that in this ball game. And then for the Dragons, it's one and done. Allow one shot, clean the glass, start going the other way, and that leads into the next key. Get out and run. They want to run. That's when they're at their best. Get out and get easy points.
Johnston making their fifth straight state championship appearance, which is the most consecutive appearances in the title game. And for Dowling Catholic, trying to win their first title since, as they get things going with Zedeker. The Maroons with the ball. Here's a three ball. Trenton off the mark, and it's going to come down to Eileen Tankey. Out ahead, Kinnitz is going to be blocked. That is Zedeker. To the side, the layup too strong. There is a lot of juice in the building, folks.
There is, and you can tell by the way these players are getting up and down the floor and the way Zedeker exploded off the floor to get that block.
Dowling last won the title back in 2014, which they beat Southeast Polk. Here's Kinnitz rising up, and that's wide of the mark. Zedeker with the board. 5'10 junior bringing it ahead. Going to be going on to play collegiate basketball in 2 years at Creighton. Again, just a junior. Going to be double-teamed by Tanky and Riley. And a steal by Kinnitz, but a foul here going to be called on Kinnitz, the sophomore.
And see right away what Johnston wants to do, put a lot of pressure on Zedeker. She's their main ball handler. They came out to try to double-team and pinch as much as they could, back up into the corner in that half-court line. Did a good job, but you know as the Maroons, you have to step to every pass because this defense is going to come after you.
Putting it on the deck, now Moeller for three. That's her first bucket of the ball game. Ellie Moeller, the sophomore, able to connect.
Shooting 34% from beyond the arc, plays a lot in the interior, but can step out, showing her range right there.
Tanky, gonna give it up to Kinnitz. Now the skip pass to Riley for three. Can't get the answer. And the rebound comes to Caitlin Moeller, the freshman.
Well, we talked about the fact that these two teams met up earlier in the regular season. So you've got a lot of game film on one another. You know tendencies and you know what you need to do against certain personnel.
Zedeker will reset. Guarded by Riley. Avoids the double team. Now gives way to Olsen. 10 on the shot clock. As the Maroons look to go to work. Down to five, Zedeker gonna have to create in the paint. Gonna be fouled on the shot with 2 seconds left on the shot clock.
Well, that's a tough one for the Dragons. You get them down late in the shot clock and a little bailout foul. You're able to stay right on the hip of Zedeker. Try to go straight up and down, try to stay vertical instead. Lewis leans in and bodies up and gets a foul.
So Zedeker to the line, 81% on the season. And able to knock down the free throw for her first point. There's a good look at Chad Gillick. In his 20th season overall as a head coach, has over 256 wins as Zedeker hits both free throws.
And he said this season, after losing the title game a year ago, they kind of went back and took a look at the game film and realized that, you know what, we need to do some things to become a more cohesive team. And so they've done a lot of team bonding and worked together to have that camaraderie and that cohesiveness. And it has worked very well for them. He said this group for Johnston is very close and plays very well together.
Zedeker caught up again. Johnston can slap it on you defensively. Holding opponents here at the state tournament under 30% shooting. Here's Moeller at the side of the backboard. Shot clock continues on. Zedeker trying to get free. Down to two. We'll just hoist it up. And the rebound to Imani Jenkins.
Well, the defense is on tonight for Johnston. They are doing a good job of really frustrating the Maroons. And there's a good look at Eileen Tanky and what she can do with that little fadeaway jumper right in the middle of the lane.
The Iowa State recruit able to get Johnston on the board. Smarting after the last game against Dowling, she was held to a season low, just 3 points. Zedeker, gonna be caught up by Riley. They're gonna say it's tied up. Possession arrow will give it to Johnston.
You know, Coach Gillick said that a lot of times, or sometimes during the regular season, as we get a look at Tanky, avoiding contact with that step back. Sometimes during the season, his defense maybe wouldn't show up and play to their potential. It did not hurt them throughout the season. They were able to get away with it. In this game tonight, you have got to play really good defense, and they are doing that. And you have to have a player like Eileen Tanky, who is hot right now to start this ball game. It took her a little bit of time the other day in the semifinals to get going, but here tonight she's on fire.
Tanky leading all of 5A in 3-point field goal percentage, better than 50%. Knotted this one up at five.
Well, earlier we saw Tanky get in the middle of the lane, hit the step back and the fadeaway. Here she spots up and knocks down a big three. They are doing a really good job of trying to contain Zetica right there as she spins, coming with the double team.
Especially as she tries to spin back to her left. Again, lots of traffic. It's Dowling Catholic. Oh, it's going to be a charge. Tritton a little too strong inside.
Well, the way they're overplaying, you have to start cutting back door. Lewis slides over, gets there in time to draw the charge. But this defense right now for Johnston is really overwhelming Dowling. They are not able to get into any kind of an offensive flow because of those double teams that are coming.
So Dowling Catholic to the bench for the first time. Macy Harnden will check in. And she's out on the floor trying to pick up at the point guard position. They're guarding Riley on the opposite side. Here's Jenkins working in on Moeller, and Ellie Moeller will pick up her first. And Jenkins will go to the line.
Well, the Maroons are a straight man-to-man defense. They try to play fundamentals. They try to force you to your offhand. They got that ball down deep into Jenkins, and she just muscled her way in to the basket.
Jenkins misses the first during the offseason. Monty Jenkins relocated into the Johnston School District. Last two previous years played at Des Moines North. And at 77%, missed both free throws right there.
Now they've got, I thought they were going to have Tritton bring the ball to get Zetica to the off guard, which they did. They got her the ball, let her get a drive and a straight line drive.
Zetica now with four. Riley on the attack to the rack. And a foul on the floor before the shot. And this is going to go against Harnden.
That last opportunity for Dowling was Tritton brought the ball up and then got it over to the wing with Zetica, where she could get set up and find the corner and turn downhill and drive.
Kinnitz three, bring it up.
Now, Kinnitz is a player that has cracked the starting lineup, first year starter. She's more of a player that puts the ball on the floor and can finish at the rim, but showing her range there.
This is gonna stay with Dowling Catholic, so the Dragons able to find their sophomore in the corner here.
So a little inside out action as that inbounds pass came inside and Jenkins was able to kick it out to Kinnitz.
Zetica looking to go to work. Well, Kinnitz has done a tremendous job defensively on Zetica so far. Harnden to Zetica. Moeller for three. It's going to be wide of the mark. And the Dragons will get it right back.
And you rush those shots when you see the defense flying at you and you just get maybe a little pump fake and then the defense flies in your face.
Just heard head coach Kristen Meyer in the background. We want to remind you we have the coaches mic'd up again for this state tournament. And during the quarter break and through timeouts throughout this one, we'll get a little more insight into the game. Ari Phillips into the contest. Outstanding freshman for Johnston. And a charge.
Now a legal screen.
A legal screen going to be called against Riley. That'll be her first.
Just trying to break Lewis free. Move just enough that the official made that call.
Each team with three team fouls. Johnston sticking to the man-to-man.
And they're really doubling up when Zetica has the ball. As you can see, Jenkins left her player, went with Lewis to try to double-team and shut down the driving lane.
Moeller being harassed. Shot clock winding down inside of six. Younger Moeller, Ellie, gets the shot to fall.
Not sure how she got it to fall. She had to adjust mid-air to get up and underneath the defense.
Tanky for three. Got it!
Coach Gillick feels like she might be the best shooter in the state, and so far here in the first quarter, she's proving him right.
Zediker has it denied.
Tried to go up with just that one hand scoop shot on the layup, but Jenkins right there to swat it away.
Lewis, the deep three, no. Phillips in the paint.
Phillips just kind of hanging around. The ball got knocked back out to her, and then she went into attack mode.
Largest lead here by the Dragons. Trenton has it poked away by Phillips. Scrum for the ball. It's on the deck. And a timeout going to be taken here by Dowling Catholic. They're going to hold the possession. 52 seconds to play in the quarter. Every possession counts.
Got to take care of the basketball. Quick hands out top. Phillips doing a good job of reaching in.
Let's go to the Johnston huddle and hear from head coach Chad Gillick.
Hey, it's 20 seconds. We got to get a good stop down here. If it's under, if we got the ball for the last shot, all right, I want you to run. Just run off the clock. If they're not guarding you, that's fine. Just hold it. If we have to weave, and then run to 40, okay? 40. Use that the screen. All right, here we go, here we go.
Watch for the back pick play.
Let's go.
With Avery in. Watch, are you in? No.
Okay. Oh, Monty's out.
Watch for that back pick play.
Run four out. Let's go. That's my fault.
Here we go, here we go.
Let's go. Attitude, let's go.
So coming into the game, Avery Ryan, the senior, will check in for the first time. Also coming in is Isabella Balsley for the Johnston Dragons here.
Balsley is another very good defender for the Dragons. She's got the assignment on Zediker.
Here's Moeller. The skip pass to the corner to her sister. Can't get it to fall. Lewis with the rebound. Shot clock is off. Balsley out ahead. And they're going to hold up the shot and hold for one here.
If they would have had that opportunity, they would have gone ahead and taken advantage of it. But smart thing to do now is get set up and get the last shot of the quarter.
Johnston nationally ranked in the top 15 in the country for high school teams. Here's Tanky. Little hesitation. The jumper not there. Rebound tipped down, and Harden will get it. And that will be the end of the first 8 minutes of play. It's been fast-paced, and the Dragons have a four-point advantage. Let's go to Paul Yeager, who's standing by.
I'm here to give BJ and Laura a breather because that was quite the intense first quarter. The crowd atmosphere inside of Wells Fargo Arena is fantastic. And in a moment, we're going to go back down to the court because it's time to award the Iowa Bankers Scholarship.
Their choice. The 2024 Student Athlete Achievement Award winner for Class 5A is Grace Knutson from Cedar Falls High School in Cedar Falls. Presenting the award is Patrick Smith from First Bank in Cedar Falls. Congratulations, Grace, on receiving this scholarship, and thank you to Patrick with First Bank in Cedar Falls and the Iowa Bankers Association for their sponsorship of this award. The Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union would like to thank you.
All right, everybody, you caught me shooting baskets, and I'm trying to practice to be on the Dowling team or the Johnston team. But this is a pretty good first quarter there, BJ and Laura. What do you think so far? I mean, we talked about in the open about Ava Zediker. She's having a game where she's being guarded, double-teamed. And Laura, I don't know if you see anything different from courtside. From up here, it looks very frustrated if you're Dowling Catholic.
I would agree with that. I think that Zediker has been very frustrated. Anytime she goes somewhere, not only does she have somebody right in front of her, she has somebody in her hip pocket as well, making it very difficult for her to get any of those drives into the hoop. And that's a big part of her game, is getting inside, getting to the rim, and finishing. And then once she does that, getting that defense to back off a little bit and then shooting the outside jumper. They are not backing off at all with her.
Out on the floor for Dowling, Olsen, Moeller, Zediker, Triton, and Moeller. This three off the mark. Rebound going to be tapped down and belong to Kinnitz. She's joined out on the floor by Jenkins, Riley, Tanky, and Lewis. So each team with their starting five out on the floor. Tanky leading the way for Johnston with eight. Ellie Moeller pacing Dowling Catholic with five, Zediker with four. Here's Riley in the paint. Shifty move, can't get it to fall. Moeller will clear it.
Boy, we've seen Riley make those moves before. She is so quick with the basketball. And when she gets inside where there's a lot of arms and a lot of legs and hands in your face, you got to move quick, and she does a good job.
Northwest Missouri State is going to get a steal in Aaliyah Riley. I think they know.
I think they know it, and I think they're very excited to get her because she's going to be a difference maker for Northwest Missouri State.
A former Waukee coach, Chris Guess, as an assistant down there, he knew where to go to find great talent.
Had a little inside information to help in that decision.
And a foul going to be called. Going to be on Aaliyah Riley, and that's going to be her second. And quickly, two team fouls on Johnston here to begin the second quarter of play. And you might be familiar with this in Iowa high school basketball. Just in case you're not, there's no more one-on-one. You get five fouls in a quarter, you're going to go to the line to shoot two. Here's Zediker in the paint. The left hand gets her own rebound back. Moeller open for three. And a tough rebound by Olsen. And a two-point takedown by Johnston. That's going to be a foul on the Dragons, their third.
Zediker went inside and able to get her own rebound. And in the middle, a lot of contact. And I think that might be Riley that's picked up that foul. Is that number three?
That's number three.
That's big.
What a luxury, though. They bring in one of the top freshmen in the state, and Ari Phillips, to replace Riley here. Zediker to the rack, right over the top of Jenkins for a deuce.
Well, you have somebody in Riley who's played against Zediker for several years, knows her tendencies, and then you have a freshman come in, a nice little crossover dribble by Zediker, able to get the baseline.
Jenkins tries to skip it to Tanky. Lewis will track it down. They'll reset. Phillips, tough move, can't get the shot to fall. Jenkins with the rebound. Didn't reset the shot clock. Here's Lewis for three. And Tanky with the board and a fresh 35. Lewis in the paint, back out to Tanky, that's a three. Can't get it to fall. Lewis with another offensive rebound. Lewis the deep three, yes!
You give them that many opportunities, they're going to eventually knock one in, and that one hurt.
Her first field goal of the game. Now Dowling, can they answer? Down by five. It's going to stay with the Maroons.
Johnston doing a good job of going to the offensive glass, kicking it back out, as Lewis was the one that got that rebound, got herself out beyond the three-point line, and they got the ball back to her, and she knocked down a deep one.
Balsley back into the contest for Johnston. Also back in, Macy Harnden for Dowling Catholic. Boy, they are harassing Zediker, and it's going to be tied up. Possession arrow will give it to Johnston.
That's twice that's happened, that they've had the possession arrow, they forced the held ball, and they get the possession.
Chad Gillick dialing up the pressure on the Dowling Catholic guard. You can hear Kristen Meyer, who's no stranger to championship games. Coached Nevada to the 2015 state championship in Class 3A, and in 2016 had her team down here too as well in the state title game in 3A. Jenica Lewis finding the stroke. She's got six.
First quarter it was Tanky. Now here in the second quarter it's Lewis knocking down some big threes.
Zediker trying to find an opening against Balsley. Doesn't use the screen. Now Harnden working on Tanky. Here's Zediker, left open. Thought about it, but great recovery by the Dragons. Out ahead, Tanky. And she'll go to the line to shoot two.
I think Zediker's being a little tentative right now. She knows she has the pressure defense on her, and she gave up. She should have just pulled the trigger on that three, and instead gets herself caught as the defense recovers, and then they get out and run.
Ellie Moeller picks up the foul. That's her first. Tanky at the line. 83% on the season. Had 19 points, 11 rebounds in the semifinals against Waukee. And now in double figures with 10. And a 10-point advantage here for Johnston. This three off the mark. Phillips out ahead, Balsley. Phillips. Again, the nifty move. Lewis, the deep three. That's in and out. Tanky with the offensive board. And then the gamesmanship to hold the possession.
Now, Tanky wasn't in there in the initial battle for the rebound, but comes out of nowhere, comes to the backside, knocks it away, and then knocks it off of Harnan.
Johnston's closest game this year was a 5-point win against Ankeny Centennial in January. Otherwise, they've been rolling competition, better than 30 points a game. They've been dominant all year. Phillips, the fade.
Now that's why you can see, we talked about it in the pregame show, they're a five-headed monster. They might be a six, seven-headed monster. They just, you know, you've got Riley in foul trouble, gone to the bench, and you just replace her with Phillips, who's making plays. You got to get some players moving for the Maroons. Nobody's moving.
Zediker to Harnden. Trenton can't get the three, and Tanky makes it a one-and-done for Dowling Catholic.
And that's one of the things that they wanted to do, make it one and done, not give them second chance opportunities.
Dowling Catholic shooting right at 27% from the field. Meanwhile, Johnston, who started 0 for their first three, have now gone 50% from the field, 8 of their last 16. Balsley has it deflected away, but gets the ball back. There's 7 on the shot clock. Phillips inside Jenkins. Goes to her left, high off the glass, can't get it to fall. Moeller with the rebound for Dowling Catholic. Zediker denied by Lewis.
She just couldn't get the step around Lewis. Made a nice little jab one way, tried to get by Lewis, but Lewis stayed right with her, got that hand on the ball, knocked it away.
Avery Ryan will come back into the game. She'll spell Ari Phillips. Moeller able to get it into Zediker. Now the dump down, and a travel will be called on Olsen.
Now Olsen did the right thing, saw the double team was coming on Zediker and slipped the screen to try to get herself open. Just couldn't gather her feet as the ball came to her.
That's the fifth turnover by Dowling Catholic. Tanky into Jenkins. Tried to power it up. A block by Moeller. She had 7 in the semifinals. In fact, Dowling Catholic leads all of 5A in blocks. But the Dragons, defensively, they don't care. A steal by Balsley.
They just keep coming at you, and Zediker was getting ready to sit up and shoot a jumper. Need to have some teammates behind you, helping you out, telling you somebody's coming.
Lewis in the paint, and a foul called here on Dowling Catholic. And this is going to be on Olsen, her first.
Lewis showing off some of her moves, and a little bit of a discussion there with Coach Meyer and the official.
Johnston has outscored Dowling Catholic here 11-2 in the second quarter. Maroons trying to find that combination. Trenton will come back into the game as she'll check in for Caitlin Moeller.
You know, as the double team comes, Johnston's putting the double team on Zediker. Whoever is open needs to come and make themselves available. Holler for the basketball so Zediker can get it to them.
Here's the double team, and it will be turned over.
And see, that's what that double team does. It speeds you up, makes you do things a little quicker than what you'd want to do.
Ryan with the board. Has it taken away underneath by Harnden.
That's what Harnden does. She's that little spark plug. Comes in off the bench, gets the team going.
Listed at 5'3", not afraid to mix it up inside. The fade by Moeller, left short. Falsely able to take it away, and a timeout going to be taken here by Johnston. A 14-point advantage for the Dragons with 1:06 to play here in the first half.
And the defense has just been stifling for the Dragons. They've got a good game plan so far, not allowing Zediker to get anything set up. The rest of the team is a little bit lost.
Well, you may have noticed new lights on the exterior of Wells Fargo Arena. They're part of the one, or I beg your pardon, behind the scenes here at Wells Fargo Arena, the Girls Athletic Union has a wall listing of this year's tournament participants. Players are encouraged to find their name, snap a picture, and share it on social media with the hashtag IowaGirl. It's all part of the pageantry, and want to remind you, we do have the champions in Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union. They're going to be represented here with the champions walk and the champions parade here coming up at halftime.
Next year, they need to put a little Iowa PBS logo up there and put all our names up there, all our crew and everybody.
Especially the crew.
Absolutely. They work so hard bringing this to a state of Iowa.
All week long. Dowling Catholic trying to get things going here as the first half starting to wind down. Here's Moeller against Ryan. Just overshot the hoop. And down the court come the Dragons. Too strong of a pass from Tanky.
Boy, she let fly with that one. It was a great pass, just a little too tall for Jenkins. But they are looking to run every opportunity that they get.
Caitlin Moeller back in along with Ari Phillips for Johnston. Ryan and for Johnston will check out. Olson will check out for Dowling Catholic. So shot clock is off. Maroons down by 14. Harnden. Now to Moeller. Working in on Jenkins. Down to 5. Lewis with the steal has some time. Down to 2, out ahead to Tanky at the horn. No. What a flurry of second quarter activity here for the Johnston Dragons. They take a 25-11 lead into intermission. Let's go to Paul Yeager, who's standing by.
Thank you very much, BJ. Thank you very much, Laura. And Johnston was up 15 in their semifinal game against Waukee just on Wednesday, and they're going in at 14 here. Coming up at halftime, we have all sorts of activities, stories, and an interview coming that I think you're going to want to hear, because there's been some news made at this tournament this week as we get ready to talk to head coach Chad Gillick of the Johnston Dragons. And coach, I wrote just a note here. We said it on the broadcast. Tanky had the first quarter. Lewis had the second quarter. What did those two do well in the first half for you?
Well, the biggest thing we told those kids is that you're not going to get wide open looks, so you're going to have to be comfortable with somebody in your face. And so we practiced a lot here before we got them, taking contested shots, and they did a good job of knocking those down.
And it looks like on defense you've gone pretty aggressive on Ava Zediker with the double team. I'm guessing you're just going to keep following her the rest of the game. Why'd you feel that was important?
Well, I mean, she's averaging 24 points or 25 points a game here in the state tournament. So the more we can keep the ball out of her hands, the better it is going to be for us. So there's some opportunities out there when we are trapping, and then there's others where we're not. We're just, our girls are smart about when to do it and when not to, and who we can do it with. And so, you know, our defense has been the key, right? We've held them to 11 points. So We're playing one of the best defense. I told the kids it's going to take your best defensive effort you've ever given, and they're doing it right now.
All right, Coach, appreciate your time. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's Chad Gillick, head coach at Johnston. And, you know, we talk about all sorts of great pageantry, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to go back down to the floor now, so we've got more activity.
One of the great traditions of the Iowa Girls State Basketball Tournament is to pay tribute to all of the state champions from the previous year. Ladies and gentlemen, the Parade of Champions, presented by the Iowa Bankers Association. Let's meet the state champions, beginning in volleyball. The Class 2A champions, the Wolverines from Dyke, New Hartford, and Coach Diane Harms. The champions of Class 1A, Coach Michelle Quick, and the Eagles from Ankeny Christian. The 5A champions, Coach Jody Boat, and the Waukee Northwest Wolves. The Class 3A champions, Coach Tammy Fearbeek, and the Wolfpack from Western Christian. Honoring the champions in softball, champions of Class 5A, the Jaguars from Ankeny Centennial, and Coach Brett Delaney. The champions in Class 4A, Coach Steve Corcoran, and the Winterset Huskies. The Class 1A state champions, the Northwind Lynx, and Coach Chad Spohr. The Class 3A softball champions, Coach Adam Birdie and the Williamsburg Raiders. The softball champions in Class 2A, Coach Angela Kessler and the Regals from Iowa City, Regina. Moving to soccer, the champions of Class 2A, Coach Dan James and the Dallas Center Grimes Mustangs. The Class 3A soccer champions, Coach Eric Schaefer and the Johnston Dragons. On to the 2023 basketball champions, the Class 4A state champions, Coach Adam Jones and the Dallas Center Grimes Mustangs. Champions of Class 1A, Coach Brandon Schwab and the Golden Bears of Algona, Bishop Garrigan. The 2023 basketball champions of Class 3A, the Warriors from Sioux Center and Coach Doug Winterfeld. The Class 5A state champions, Coach Jennifer Getz and the Pleasant Valley Spartans. The Class 2A champions, Coach Bruce Dahl and the Dyke New Hartford Wolverines. Let's meet the state champions in track and field. Starting in Class 2A, Coach Rick Roberts and the Van Meter Bulldogs. Champions of Class 4A, the Waukee Northwest Wolves and Coach Ben Dewey. Class 3A champions, Coach Jessica Hotek and the Solon Spartans. Champions in Class 1A, the Warriors of Calamus Wheatland and Coach Jamie Kanucky. Now let's meet the state champion in swimming and diving, Coach Shelley Twigg and the Waukee Warriors. The state champion swimming and diving para champions, the Keokuk Chiefs, with Adeline Worcester and Coach Andrea Worcester. Here are the champions of cross country, starting in Class 4A, the Johnston Dragons and Coach Patrick Ennis. The 3A state champions, the Pella Dutch and Coach Douglas Cutler. Walking with the team is the Class 3A individual champion from Pella, Marissa Farabee.
the Class 1A champions, Coach Kelly Grothus and the Madrid Tigers. The cross-country champions in Class 2A, Coach Andrew Hamer and the Lions from Des Moines Christian. The Class 4A individual champion is Addison Dornkamp from West Des Moines Valley with Coach Tom Krigstad. The 2A individual champion, Hillary Trainer from Sumner Fredericksburg with Coach Alicia Jones. The Class 1A state champion, Noelle Steinis from Calamus Wheatland with Coach Jessica Steinis. Let's move to the 2023 golf champions. Champions at Class 2A, the Norseman from Roland Story with Coach Larry Ammerman. The Class 4A golf champions, Coach Sean Kingry and the Pleasant Valley Spartans. Champions of Class 1A, the Grundy Center Spartans and Coach Heather Gutnick. Walking with the team is the Class 1A individual champion, Abby Lindemann. Champions of Class 3A, the Gilbert Tigers with Coach Grant Walker. Walking with the team is the 3A individual medalist, Eden Lorbach. The 2A medalist is Chloe Bolte from Sumner Fredericksburg with Coach Josh Kruger. The 1A co-ed golf champions hail from Clear Lake, Megan DeLong and Elijah Anderson with Coach Colby Andrews. Now let's meet the bowling champions that were crowned last week. The 1A team champions from Comanche, the Storm, with Coach Brad Weber. Introducing the Class 2A champions, Coach Ryan Moore and the Keokuk Chiefs. The Class 3A champions, Coach Doug Teckel and the Ottumwa Bulldogs. The Class 1A bowling individual champion, Kylie Kirshner from Vinton-Shelsburg with Kurt Kirshner. Let's meet the 2023 tennis champions, the Class 1A team champions, Coach Dave Will and the Sailors from Waterloo, Columbus. The 2023 1A singles champions is Sophia Frain from Waterloo, Columbus with Coaches Dave Will and Catherine Fain. Ladies and gentlemen, your state champions from 2023 and 2024. Congratulations to all the schools, athletes, and coaches.
Congratulations to all of those champions. And state basketball isn't the only sport in the spotlight this time of year. Girls state wrestling took place in early February. We followed three-peat champion from Decorah, senior Naomi Simon, as she made a run at her fourth straight gold medal.
Wrestlers are a lot of things. They're tough, hardworking, determined, and as of 2022, they are also girls.
Wrestling is a sport that is easy to fall in love with. I think there's two types of people. There's people who love wrestling and people who don't understand wrestling.
Girls have been wrestling in Iowa for some time, but it wasn't until 2022 that the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union sanctioned the sport.
There is one thing I would like to say, and that is we've sanctioned girls wrestling.
Since then, participation has skyrocketed. The 2023-2024 season had more than 3,000 girls participating across 200 programs.
Iowa is one of the greatest states in the nation for wrestling, historically has been. So when it comes to girls wrestling, the concept wasn't so foreign. I think just us putting our stamp on it gives it legitimacy across the state and more avenues for growth.
Decorah High School powerhouse Naomi Simon is a familiar face to those in the Iowa wrestling community. She ended her high school career with an undefeated record and made history as the first four-time girls state wrestling champion.
I started wrestling when I was in seventh grade, just decided to go out. I'd done taekwondo, gymnastics, soccer, every youth sport, really, and I never really liked any of them.
Jump in the air, 25, 1, 2, 3.
I've always had a like really hard time connecting with my peers, making friends, and wrestling just turned out to be a really great place where I could make friends and meet new people. Everybody who steps foot into a wrestling room is automatically transported into a new world, like realm full of just hard work that is found nowhere else.
In the hole, at 170 pounds,
I've had so many people come up to me and say, oh, I watched you wrestle and it just made me want to go out. And I'm like, oh, that's so sweet. Like, I never intended to be the person up front. You know, I've always looked at people like Adeline Gray, Dan Gable, Spencer Lee, all of the wrestling icons. And I'm like, I want to be there. Especially within the past few months, you know, I just sort of realized that all these people are just here to help me and support me, and then I just want to give back to them. I love it, you know, it pushes me to be better. It pushes me to be a better version of myself. It allows me to help other people be better. The biggest thing I think it's taught me is how to respect everybody and still want to go out and battle them. Every opponent I face, you know, I have the utmost respect for because they're there wanting to fight me, essentially. It gives me a platform to show other people that no matter what they do, there's always a place like wrestling, or if you do basketball, there's always somewhere where you can belong. I think that the hard work, the work ethic, and everything that I've gained through wrestling is just keeps pushing me to come back. I have a wrestling addiction. I just can't leave.
And what has become an annual tradition, our conversation with Executive Director of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union, Gene Berger. And Gene, you're in that piece announcing you're going to sanction wrestling. We finished the piece with everybody standing on the platform. In just that 2 short year time frame, has it met or exceeded expectations for you? Has it exceeded it?
He's exceeded it. We were up another 800 girls from the first year, so we're over 3,000 for this year. But more importantly, our brackets were full. So instead of brackets where 10 girls wrestled to go to state, we had full brackets except for one and all of our sub-regionals. So the depth is growing.
So since it's growing, how much longer before there's a second class in wrestling?
Well, you know, I'm sure that will be a topic of this discussion into the spring. Actually, the Wrestling Advisory Committee is meeting in March. They'll make a recommendation and the board will act on that. But, you know, the depth is growing, number of schools is not, so maybe there's a dual tournament before classes, Paul.
Okay,
yeah.
That would be something
yeah,
to see. You know, one thing I've seen this week is this new court that's here, and there's a little tiny thing on that court. This is a replacement to what you had that was original to the arena. How'd this court come about?
Well, it started about 3 years ago. The old court was getting a little rough, and there were a lot of dead spots. You could hear it when they ran, you could hear it when they dribbled. I thought it was really retro, kind of good. So it took 3 years.
And what is this underneath the eye? The Gene Berger Court.
With the signature. So I have a very, very creative staff. And they just thought it would be nice because they knew 3 years of work before we got a floor for the Iowa Girl.
And it's a staff that you are not going to be spending as much time with here soon. Just before the tournament was announced,
You have said, I'm done, it's time to wake up at the lake on a little more regular basis. When
yes.
you reflect on your time here, wrestling has to be one of your achievements.
Correct. Yes.
The color pink has to be one of your achievements.
Yes.
What stands out most to you?
Well, for sure, just the level that we have raised the Iowa girl and what it's meant. I think that probably more than anything, Paul, is what I'm most proud of and what my staff works on all the time. Because it's really, really important for girls to feel that.
You have a background in marketing and branding. You have a shirt on right now that is reflective. We just saw all the champions walk by.
Yeah.
The pink shirt, I was asking Peyton Peterson from Dyke New Hartford. She has a chance to win a seventh pink shirt. I
yes.
said, are you going to make a quilt just out of these things? She says they're all in her closet. They're all ready to go. When you hear stories like that, what's that make you think?
Well, you know, I think what we try to do is focus on one girl and the Iowa girl and what she means to us. You know, they're very well-rounded. They don't just do one thing. They're in 4-H, they're in music, they're in speech. And when you tell the story of the Iowa girl, I think it resonates with everyone. You know Iowa girls. I know Iowa girls. I was an Iowa girl.
And we're appreciative of you. And I know in signage outside, inside the arena, there's a sign that says thank you. The arena is, there's a sign, thank you for your leadership, Gene. The building, when you go outside tonight, you'll see it. It's pink, Gene. I have to say thank you. It's been fun with you.
Thank you.
And I know it's been
it.
An emotional week for a couple of things, so we'll just leave it at that.
Thank you.
Gene Berger,
thank you,
you so very much. All right, that is our now outgoing executive director, Gene Berger of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union. Now, we have highlights, but do we have Coach ready now? Okay, we're going to go to a break. When we come back, we'll talk with Coach Krista Meyer, hopefully, and give you some highlights. But we'll be back in a moment as our doubleheader night continues here on Iowa PBS.
Join Iowa PBS as we take an adventure across Iowa's scenic byways. We explore the historic sites, unique attractions,
hi,
and natural beauty along the way.
Road Trip Iowa, coming this spring to Iowa PBS.
You tune to Iowa PBS for many reasons. Children's programming that educates, fact-based journalism that informs, cultural programming that inspires, and nature programming that feeds your curiosity. All made possible because of viewers like you. Do your part and donate during festival. Call 800-779-7000 or donate at iowapbs.org.
Johnston in the lead, 25-11 here at halftime with Dowling Catholic, and Maroon head coach Kristen Myers with his coach. This is a game that Ava Zediker was needed to be big. She's been big for you all year. Johnston's double teaming her. So how do you get her involved and maybe somebody else to get some movement around it to get some other folks going?
That's really the million-dollar question, isn't it? We talked about a couple things, you know, at halftime. I think we have to have some other girls step up, drive harder, call for the ball, step to a gap if they double Ava. But we can't keep running Ava ragged when we need some other girls just to take the ball and go find some ways to score.
Now, you talk about getting girls to move, but you also kind of need them to slow down because Johnston's elevating their pace of play. How do you do both of those things?
Yeah, I think it's an aggressive mentality, but under control. So you still have to be able to do a retreat dribble to see, you know, if there's help coming. But we have to have a downhill driving aggressive mentality.
All right, Kristen Meyer, appreciate your time. Thank you so much, Coach.
Thank you.
That's head coach of the Dowling Catholic Maroons, Kristen Meyer. And this is how we got to halftime. Let's take a look at some of those earlier action. We call them highlights in the business. Early on, it was Johnston. And it was also some pretty good defense. Ava Zediker was on a 4-0 run, 5-0 run by herself to start the game for plays like that. She later ended up at the free throw line on a nice move to the baseline. But then it became a lot of Johnston and a lot of this player. Eiley Tankey, the future Cyclone. She committed after her sophomore year, big three there. Let's see, Tankey is 3 of 6 from the field, 2 of 4 from 3, 6 rebounds, total of 10 points.
And Eileen Tanky has been a wrecking machine for the Johnston Dragons. Let's find out what's going to unfold in this second half. B.J. Shave and Laura Leonard, hopefully they were able to catch their breath. They're ready for quarter number three.
Well, it certainly was fast-paced in that first half, and it seemed to be to the benefit of the Johnston Dragons.
Yeah, and that's what they wanted to do. They wanted to speed up the Maroons, and that's exactly what they did with that double team, pushing Zediker away from the hoop, not allowing them to get in any kind of flow. And they'd turn them over, and then they'd go the other way. So the speed and the pace has got to change if you're the Maroons, and if you're the Dragons, keep things going the way you did before.
Well, the statistics really show that, too. In the first half, dominated by Dowling Catholic, or by Johnston over Dowling, holding the Maroons to just 4 of 19, 8 turnovers, which turned into 10 Johnston Dragon points. And let's play some basketball here in the second half. The starting five for Dowling Catholic, it is Olsen, Moeller, Zediker, Tritton, and Moeller. For the Dragons, it'll be Kinnitz, Jenkins, Aaliyah Riley with those three fouls back into the game, Tanky and Lewis. So the Maroons with the basketball to begin the second half. This is a team that is averaging better than 62 points a game. They average about 9 three-pointers per contest. Right now they just have 1 3, and you see the scoreboard. Here's Zediker, trying to step back. Now the pass to Moeller. And Jenkins with the rebound will outlet it ahead.
Even when Zediker gets by the initial wave of defense, there is somebody else right there, and Jenkins was right there to keep her away from shooting that shot and had to pass it off.
Maroons need baskets. Zediker thinking about the baseline.
Boy, right as she was going to drive baseline, Tanky ran over to try to shut down that side.
Third time we mentioned they played against one another. They know each other very well. Here's Tanky to Lewis. One too many passes, and Dowling Catholic will end up with the basketball.
Yeah, you're right, exactly. One too many passes. Just go ahead and take that up to the rim. Trying to be unselfish, and that's fine, but when you're in that close, go ahead and go up.
Riley guarding Zediker. The skip to the corner. The three ball off the mark. Zediker with the rebound and the foul on Riley, and that's going to be number 4 on Aaliyah Riley.
Well, she sat a good portion of the second quarter, and now she's going to have to go to the bench for probably a fairly long time here in the second half. Zediker rises high, and Riley's just trying to box out. Zediker was already in the air, and there was contact underneath.
Clearly frustrated is Aaliyah Riley as Ari Phillips, a freshman, in for her. We're left open as Olsen will not take the shot. Now to Zediker.
And this is a situation, as Coach Meyer said, you just have to have somebody else step up and start taking some shots. They seem to be very tentative. They're looking for Zediker to do things. Somebody else has to take the initiative and work the ball towards the basket or rise up and knock down some jumpers.
Tanky. Eiley with the three, left it short, and Phillips will track down the rebound for Johnston. Jenkins now inside. The power move, can't get it to fall. Moeller with the rebound. And tries to outlet it ahead, deflected away by Johnston. So this Dragon team dominant, not only in the state of Iowa, but in the Midwest. They have wins against the top-ranked team in Minnesota, Hopkins. And then a win against Nebraska's. And it just wasn't a win. It was a shellacking that they put on Nebraska's top-ranked team in Millard West throughout the season. We mentioned they're ranked in the top 15 nationally. Zediker's drive, can't get at the ball, but will go to the line to shoot two as Jenkins will pick up the foul.
Coach Jellick talked about the fact that they wanted to test their team a little bit this season to start right back in November, and they did, and were able to get a couple of really good games against Hopkins and Millard West, and he kind of felt like, even though Millard was one of the top teams in Nebraska, maybe not quite to the level of some of the top teams here in the state of Iowa.
Zedeker able to knock both of them down. She has eight. It's her first points here in the late half. So a little bit of a different pace as compared to the beginning of the game.
Yeah, it was pretty frenzied to start this ball game, especially those first 4 minutes.
Kinnett's able to track that one down. Finds Jenkins. Avoids the triple team to Phillips. Shot clock winding down here. Kinnett's in the paint. Not going to be able to, I wasn't going to say her shot got, was
got
able to get off
hand.
Before the
yeah.
horn. Dowling ends up with the ball anyways.
And they are just chasing Zedeker everywhere.
Bowler on the block. Again, some long possessions, and Phillips with the steal. To the rack.
Twice in this ball game that Phillips has done that. Ball handlers for the Maroons need to protect that ball. They're dribbling it right out in front. That's so inviting for a player like Phillips who's got the quick hands.
She has six now. Left alone, and Dowling able to get the bucket. Ellie Olson with the basket. As Triton with a great feed.
Yeah, drew the defense, knew exactly, ran that set play, able to split the two defenders, make a nice pass over to Olson.
Phillips with some quality minutes with Aaliyah Riley on the bench in foul trouble. One going to be turned over.
Boy, Olson was down there, needed to cut into the lane, cut to the basket and call for the ball.
Bowler on the block, the fade. Gets the friendly roll, Caitlin Moeller with her first basket.
Might have gotten away with a little bit of a travel. I think she might have changed pivot feet, but that's all right, Dowling will take that.
Dowling Catholic with the strongest schedule in the state. Able to get here, coming in at 21-4. And running into a buzzsaw tonight. There's Lewis. And she knocks down her third triple of the game, now in double figures with 11.
And just when Dowling Catholic is starting to make a little bit of a run, you get a big three like that.
The answer, no. And a rebound to Johnston.
When right away, as soon as that ball came off the rim, they were out and running, filling lanes. Good job by the Maroons to get back in transition.
Here's Phillips. Tough rebound for Zedeker. As it's a 13-point advantage for the Dragons. Zedeker will launch and hit.
She has not done that all night long. She has been very focused in on putting the ball on the floor, trying to take it inside. A little step back jumper with some good defense on her.
Nearing the 2-minute mark here in the third quarter. Lewis looking to go to work. Boy, the fade. Can't get at the ball, and Dowling Catholic with an opportunity to cut it into single digits. Zedeker in the paint. Tough shot, can't get at the ball. Tanky with the tough rebound here for Johnston.
Doing a better job of shaking the defender and getting open in the middle.
Jenkins working in on Moeller. And a foul going to be called here on Ellie Moeller. Sophomore will pick up her second, just the first team foul of the third quarter for Dowling.
Jenkins so strong as she gets the ball down in the block, and Moeller just leaned those hands on her, leaned them down instead of staying vertical.
Jenkins heading to Marquette. Committed prior to the start of the season.
They met up with the Maroons earlier. She had a double-double, 15 points, 14 rebounds. of those 14, five offensive. So she went to the offensive glass, got some second chance opportunities for her teammates.
Arndon coming back into the game for the first time in the late half here for Dowling Catholic, as Ellie Moeller will sit. It's a little bit of a smaller lineup for the Maroons out on the floor. And Johnston will bring Avery Ryan back into the game along with Isabel Balsley. So it's Tanky, Phillips, Ryan, Balsley.
Matching personnel with personnel. You know, take out your big, I'll take mine out. We'll go a little bit smaller and see how these small lineups do against one another.
And one here for Layla Tritton.
That's the kind of aggressiveness that Coach Meyer was looking for when Paul talked to her at halftime. Said, we need to have some others step up, be aggressive on the drive. And she did with a nice spin move, took it in strong and drew contact.
Allie Tanky will pick up the foul. That'll be her first. Free throw not there for Tritton. Still a 10-point game here. Lewis will put it on the deck, back out to Tanky. Uh-oh. Left her open for three. Tanky with a rare miss from the outside. Lewis will now go to the line to shoot two.
Well, the screen came, two defenders went with the ball handler. That allowed Tanky to pop out free. Lewis was able to get her the basketball. Came up short, but crashed the boards and did a good job of getting into traffic to pull that rebound.
And Jenica Lewis able to knock that one down, now at 12 in the state tournament. You might have heard of her before, Jenica Lewis. Of course, a lot of coaches have heard of her. Holds over 50 Division I scholarship offers. Had that primarily coming into her freshman season.
You know, and Coach Gillick said, you know, a year ago, she was a little tentative when she got at the high school level as a freshman. Now she's more comfortable, sees the floor well, doing a good job of making herself available to receive the basketball or also creating for herself.
Nearly across the half court line, and now they're gonna say she stepped on the line, so over and back gonna be the call. Tough defense there that time by Avery Ryan.
Little sly smile by Avery Ryan as Muller was towing the half court line. Just a little bump right there by Ryan. And the toe of Muller goes over into the backcourt.
So Johnston will get the ball back. Shot clock is off. 33 seconds to play here in the third quarter, and a 12-point advantage for Johnston. When these teams first met at the beginning of the season, Johnston won 65-53. The second game, a really big-time defensive battle, 43-31. And guess what? The defense, if you're a fan of it, it's even better here in the state championship.
It's on display here tonight.
Riley back into the game, going to hold for one here. Tanky inside Jenkins. Going to be tied up by Zedeker. Possession arrow will keep it with Johnston. There's 5 seconds to go in the quarter.
He spread the floor that time, and Zedeker over on the opposite side of the floor just comes crashing down, digging to tie up Jenkins.
Tanky has that one deflected away. Now inside of 2 seconds to play in the quarter.
Yeah, I was going to say, Tanky is the inbounder. She's the one that maybe you want to take this shot, see if you can rub her off of some screens.
Moeller able to pick that one off, and that'll be the end of the third quarter. 34-22. Johnston with the 12-point lead, trying to win their third state championship and their fifth straight state tournament appearance. Let's go to the Dowling Catholic huddle here and hear from head coach Kristen Meyer.
Setting this street and then stay. Yeah. Hey, that was a good quarter. Okay. Make sure we're still talking defensively. If we need to switch anything, just talk through it. Offensively, hey, way to get an and one, right? We are attacking. Has anyone gotten a charge yet? We're going. Listen, when you drive, Ole's not going to stay here. Kind of turn a little bit into a Barkley. Ole's coming to here. Pass, score, pass, one dribble, go. Okay? But we still have to be downhill attacking. Good job defensively. We only give up 9 points, right? That's a great quarter. Make sure we find Tanky and Jenica early. Keep boxing out. Let's run a Chicago. This is Ole. Right? So, Katie, Layla, Ava, Ellie, right? Run through it. When Ole screens, when you attack, Ellie's gonna pop. Okay? Ellie pops, Ole will be low. Read it. If we don't have it, we're offense with Ellie on the perimeter. Hey, in the offense, we're okay. In the offense, keep going downhill. Come on, fight back right now. What? Your perimeter. Ava, Ava.
Well, and you could hear that, again, get into attack mode. Turn it, get downhill. See if you can get the and one, and I like the question, has anybody picked up a charge yet? No, so continue to take it in.
Coach Beyer, this year's recipient of the Golden Plaque of Distinction Award, of course, in her eighth season at Dowling Catholic. And yes, she did coach Caitlin Clark.
Yeah, a lot of questions, Coach Beyer, the other day after their semifinal win, because that was right after Caitlin Clark had announced that she was going to go take her game to the next level. And she said that Caitlin Clark has been in touch with her multiple times throughout the season and over the course of her career at the University of Iowa, and stayed in touch, showed up to practices, talked to the players. So it's a nice connection that they have.
Leah Riley picking up the foul. Now we'll check out as Zediker knocks down the free throw. Zediker now with 12 in the game and has scored all of Dowling's points here in the late half. So it's back to a 10-point game here. Ari Phillips into the lineup here for Johnston, joined by Kinnitz, Jenkins, Tanky, and Lewis. Here's Jenkins trying to work in on Moeller. Little cut pass, going to be picked off by Dowling Catholic by Olson. She's joined by Moeller, Zediker, Tritton, and Moeller.
Jenkins thought that Tanky was going to make that cut and didn't cut very hard, and the pass is already made. The Maroons able to pick it off. That's one of the few turnovers that Johnston has made here in this ballgame.
Zediker, the step back three. It's a 7-point game and a timeout taken here by Johnston. Just like that, 7-point game, 7 minutes to play. And the Maroons starting to crawl their way back into it.
A couple of different times here in the second half, Zediker has been able to get loose with that crossover dribble, stay behind the 3-point line, and knock it down.
Let's go inside of the Dragon huddle and hear from their head coach, Chad Gillick.
She goes to her left like we're getting beat. Just let her go. Don't let her get there. You're trying to beat her, and then she steps back, okay? She's playing really well right now. We're not in the game on this end of the floor. Right? It's our offense right now that's not flowing. We're not moving. We're not looking for our players, right? We got our two scorers right here. We're not setting screens for them, right? You're not being aggressive down there. You just got to be aggressive. You can score, right? Okay, you got it, right? Hey, hey, let's run Dragon right now. Can you run Dragon? Okay, set a good pick for Eile in the corner. Ari, you get it, go and make a good screen, okay? Let's go. Go. You're not in the corner.
I like what he said. I mean, they have kind of taken a step back. Their aggressiveness is not there on offense. They're kind of settled in to a mode of where they're not taking the ball to the hoop. They're not moving as much as they were in the first half, and they need to get back that intensity.
Well, we talk about Johnston's defense. How about Dowling Catholics?
Yeah, they have done a really good job, and their defense has just done a great job of improving throughout the entire season. They have worked hard on it, and that's kind of their mindset. They do like to play defense, and they play it hard. They're straight man-to-man. They'll go after you, get some backside help. But this is a team that when you know you're matched up against them, you're going to have to fight for every point you get.
Zediker picks up her first. Phillips to the line. I mean, Johnston came into the state championship game averaging about 72 points a game. Now sitting at 34.
It's not unlike the second time they matched up in the regular season. We talked about the fact that it was certainly a defensive struggle.
Danke hustles for the board. Now to Jenkins. And Moeller will pick up the foul. That'll be her third. Rebounding offensively for Johnston. They've done an outstanding job tonight. That is going to be their 11th offensive rebound.
That's just 11 more opportunities that you've given your team once you go to that offensive glass.
So Isabel Balsley back into the contest for Johnston, replaces Phillips. And Amani Jenkins gets her first point of the night with that free throw. So we're at 8 with 6:30 to play. Moeller uses a screen to her left. And that defense just suffocating, forcing yet another turnover. That's the 13th of the night.
Yeah, that's too many, I know, for Coach Meyer's liking, but this Johnston defense is doing a good job of just frustrating Dowling Catholic every time they get the ball into the front court.
Lewis able to track it down. The foul here called on Dowling Catholic. That's going to be their third here with 5:45 to play.
Well, and again, rules have changed this season. 5 fouls in a quarter. At the end of the quarter, it's wiped clean and you start all over again. And so the quicker and the sooner that Johnston gets into that bonus, they will be stepping to the free throw line.
Caitlin Moeller picked up the foul. That's her third. Lewis, the step back. Oh my.
Boy, with a lot of traffic and a lot of hands in the face. Nice jab step and step back.
Lewis with 16.
Balsley move her feet to stay with Zediker.
And Zediker able to knock that one down, and a timeout going to be taken by Dowling Catholic here.
You're going to get a good look at what Jenica Lewis can do. Little jab step in, shakes the defender, and Moeller and able to step back, get those feet behind the line and knock it down.
Well, live streaming now, YouTube, X, Facebook, and iowapbs.org. Don't miss a minute of today's championship action. Catch the live stream on YouTube, X, Facebook, and iowapbs.org. Well, it's been an amazing tournament. And right now, we're seeing two of the two best teams in Class 5A here going toe-to-toe for the third time this year. Johnston has an answer for every time that Dowling Catholic gets a little closer.
Yeah, they have been able to cut into that lead a little bit a couple of different times, and then the Dragons come down and make a big play, get a step-back three, get an offensive rebound and a putback.
Well, you may have noticed some new lights on the exterior of Wells Fargo Arena. They're actually part of a $1 million lighting project to make the building more visible. The system is able to change colors to complement events inside, like the pink projected now of the Iowa Girls High School State Basketball Tournament. And it's just been an amazing week. City of Des Moines decking itself out, especially in the downtown area, for the state basketball tournament. Thousands of fans have came here. In fact, many are have vacation weeks down here. Riley's shot, she has 4 fouls. They've clarified that with us. 4 fouls for Aaliyah Riley. She's up back out on the floor.
No, she's had a lot of time on the bench. Phillips has done a nice job of filling in for her.
And Tanky able to get the rebound. We'll outlet it ahead to Jenica Lewis.
Hankey's done a nice job on the glass as well.
Now Tanky. Trying to back her way in. The little turnaround J is good for Tanky. She's got 12.
That's a move that you can tell she's worked on a ton in the gym, in her driveway. She knew exactly where the defender was, what she needed to do. Little fadeaway jumper.
This deep three by Zedeker. 21 on the night for Ava Zedeker.
Give her that kind of room, and she's going to pull the trigger. She might start looking to do that a little bit more as time winds down.
Let's see how much Dowling will crank up the defense here down the stretch. Great pass from Lewis to Jenkins. We'll have to earn them at the line. Foul going to be on Tritton. That'll be her second. And that is the fourth team foul on Dowling Catholic with 3:38 to play.
This is how the Maroons are going to be able to climb back into this ball game as Zedeker just stares down the hoop and pulls the trigger. And that last possession for the Dragons as Jenica Lewis turns the corner, makes that dribble drive. The defense had to shift over, which allowed her then to make that little pocket pass over to Jenkins.
Jenkins, one out of two. Dowling Catholic with measured possessions here in the second half. Tritton thought about it. Now Zedeker to work on Bolsley. Crossover. Gave up the ball and it's turned over. Lewis out ahead to Bolsley, who's going to roll it back in for Johnston. Lewis the three. That's her fifth three-pointer of the night for Jenica Lewis.
It just was pure. You could see we had a great angle on it as it left her hand. You knew it was going to go in, and Tritton looked at the bench and said, I was there. I had a hand in the face.
And Dowling Catholic right back with an answer here on this end. Zedeker now with 23. Kinnitz has it poked away. It's going to stay with Johnston. 2:28 to play here in the game. And Macy Harnden will come back into the contest. Well, Iowa High School girls basketball has been influenced, Laura. I mean, there has been a load of talent. You've heard the Division I schools that a lot of these players are going to be going to. And you think about it, with both Lewis and Zedeker, they're going to be playing on the same club team coming up this summer, the All-Iowa Attack. What a dynamic duo, but battling it out here, starting next week, on the same squad. Pretty interesting.
Yeah, that is, and that's, you get into those summer teams, and on that circuit, you're going to have different teammates that you're going to face when you're in high school on the opposite side, and so you're going to have to get along with them for a while, and then you're going to have to go up against them for a while.
Free throw not there for Jenica Lewis. Back to a lot of club players out on the floor. It's a year-round activity as Lewis able to knock down the free throw here. 45-34, 2:14 to play. Zedeker will attack. Can't get it to fall. Tanky with the board.
Was able to get that straight line drive, couldn't connect. And again, it's one and done.
That one going to be deflected away by Moeller.
And Tanky wanted the foul.
Inside of two to play. Allie Tanky, 12 points, 10 rebounds, a double-double for her tonight. The skip to the corner, that's Triton. Can't get it to fall. Marndon with the board for the Maroons. Trying to do everything they can to get it in the hands of Zedeker.
And they've given themselves three opportunities on this possession. Boy, Balsley, just so talked about it, the quick feet that she has. She's a soccer player, and you can tell is the way she is staying with Zetiker.
Moeller from the outside, can't get it to fall. Tanky with another board.
Now Johnston is probably going to take a little time, work the clock.
And a timeout going to be taken here by Johnston. 1:04 to play in the 5A championship. Let's hear what the Maroons have to say.
What point is he subbing people? I don't know. All right, hey, we need one stop here. So you have 30, you have 10. Okay. You have, I think Riley's in. Okay. So you probably have 23, either 2 or 23. If it's 2, help in the lane. If it's 23, normal. Okay? Don't let her come and sit in front of you. Right? She doesn't get to step in front of you. Go ahead and deny her a little bit more. Get one D stop, then we're pushing. Get to the free throw line. Right? Then, hey, we got 1 minute.
Let's go.
Play hard. Play hard for 1 minute. Score some points. Let's go.
Well, it's all about defense. It's all about stops. So get the stop. And then once you get it, you get that stop, continue on and push tempo. Try to get that traditional three-point play if you can. You know, you look at this Dowling lineup, only one senior on this team. So they are going to have a lot of firepower next back for next season.
So is Johnston.
And so is Johnston. We might see this matchup again next season.
Here's Tanky. From the elbow, able to knock it down, Eileen Tanky.
Now they ran the clock, they ran that little bit of a weave up top to try to waste some time, and Tanky knocks down a big bucket, which might be that final nail for the Dragons.
And they're going to be able to dribble out the clock here if they can bring it into the half court, but a foul going to be called here on the Maroons. How about this for Johnston, falling last year to Pleasant Valley in the state championship? Really upset. They had another loaded team, making their fifth straight state championship appearance. And Chad Gillick, he was honest with us. He said last year wasn't one of his favorite years coaching, but this year, he said they knew they had talent. They knew they were going to make it their way back here to the state tournament at least, but he said it's been more pleasurable due to the chemistry. He said this team is having a blast, and you're seeing that out on the court right now.
Yeah, and it's all about how a team gets along, gets together, the team chemistry, how they gel together. Kind of starting to celebrate here in the backcourt, and you look at it, you talked about the five straight championship games. Well, they won in 2020, 2022, and now they're going to win here again in 2024. So they like even years. They were runner-up in those other years in 21 and 23.
Zetiker with 25, and that's going to do it. The Johnston Dragons are your 2024 Class 5A state champs. What a run by the Dragons, and capped off with another state title. Now 26-0. Jenica Lewis leading the way with 20. Allie Tanky with a double-double, 15 points, 13 rebounds in her final game.
Well, quite a performance right from the beginning. The defensive game plan that the Dragons had for the Maroons was spot on. They were able to contain Zetiker. Yes, she got away in the second half, was able to shake the defense, knock down some threes. But I'll tell you, they set the tone in that first quarter and said, this is what we're going to do. We're going to double team you. We're going to try to take the ball out of your hands, make the others beat us. And so you got to credit the Johnston Dragons for a really good game plan coming into this state championship game.
And the t-shirts.
They love the t-shirts. That's, you know, it's interesting. You hear the players talk, and we go talk to them after games. They know what's at stake. That pink t-shirt means a lot to them.
Let's turn it over to Joe Hammond.
Presenting the awards is Brent Johnson, president of the Iowa Farm Bureau. Joining him are members of the IGHSAU Board of Directors, Russ Adams, Jennifer Donalds, Zach Clark, Greg Defoe, Travis Fleschner, Tanya Moe, Ron Fodness, and Governor Kim Reynolds. From Johnston, Eile Tanke. From Dowling Catholic, Ellie Muller. From Cedar Falls, Grace Knutson. From Davenport North, Divine Borage. From Dowling Catholic, Ava Zedeker. And your 5A All-Tournament Team Captain from Johnston, Jenica Lewis. Fans, the Iowa Pork Producers would like to present the Top Producer Award for the 5A Championship Game. Presenting the award is Taylor Anderson of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union. This year's Top Producer of the 5A Championship Game, from Johnston, Jenica Lewis. Now, fans, please help us recognize the 2024 Class 5A runner-up, the Dowling Catholic Maroons and head coach Kristen Meyer. Fans, let's hear it for the 2024 Class 5A champion, the Johnston Dragons and head coach Chad Gillick. Johnston Dragons, your 2024 Class 5A state champion, as they celebrate with their student body. What a run for Johnston.
It really has been, and it's going to keep going, probably. They've got a lot of talent on that team, and I would venture a guess to say that we will see them back here at the state tournament next season, and I think we'll see this Dowling Maroon team as well back here at the state tournament. A lot of young talent on both of these teams, quite a show by both of them.
We've got more basketball coming your way for the Class 3A title game. But first, let's go to Paul Yeager, who's standing by.
That's a very trusting team to give the trophy to the fans, and they gave it back right away. Nice job, Johnston. Only two teams held Johnston below 50 points all season. Both of them were Dowling Catholic. Both were losses. 76-2, that's a pretty good run in 3 years. That's going to do it for game one of basketball here on our doubleheader on Iowa PBS. For all of us here on the crew, we are excited that you have been with us so far. Stay tuned as game number two coming up next, Solon and Estherville Lincoln Central. Congratulations again to Dowling Catholic. This has been high school basketball on Iowa PBS.
Funding provided by
Muskell Lighting is honored to support Iowa PBS. We're an Iowa company that lights local schools, community fields, and stadiums, arenas, and venues in more than 125 countries. While our reach is global, our commitment is local.
And by Fairway Meat and Grocery. For more than 80 years, Fairway has been proud to be an active part of the communities we serve. Learn more at fairway.com.
Across Iowa, hundreds of neighborhood banks strive to serve their communities, provide jobs, and help local businesses. Iowa banks are proud to back the life you build. Learn more at iowabankers.com.
With our Iowa roots and Midwestern values, Farmers Mutual Hale is committed to offering innovative farm insurance for America's farmers, just as we have for six generations. Farmers Mutual Hale, America's crop insurance company.